हेलो हेलो
हेलो
या हाय जी भाई, कैन यू हियर मी?
या आई कैन हियर यू। कैन
ओके
यू हियर
गुड।
मी?
यस आई कैन हियर, बट माय वॉइस इज इकोइंग, इट्स लिटिल बिट इको इज देयर।
वंस अगेन आई विल जस्ट कनेक्ट टू माय हेडसेट।
ओके
जस्ट गिव मी अ मिनट।
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Are you
I
still
have
hearing the echo?
no, it's better now. So I have also shared my screen. I hope you can see that.
Yeah, I can
Right?
see.
Okay, good. So see, first of all, you just give me your brief introduction. Just tell me like what is your background in the language and what is the exact requirement to learn, and then I'll just guide you about the course, and then we'll start with the demo lecture content directly. Okay?
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Like right now I'm in Germany and I had coaching till B1 in
Okay.
Volkshochschule.
Okay, good.
But before taking the exam, like this corona things and all happened, and I was not at all ready for taking the exam also. But I had classes till B1, and then I was very low in my grammar,
Okay.
so I couldn't take exam like if I am bad in the grammar. So I stepped back, and again I didn't pay the fees for the exams, and I thought of taking exam again, B1 exam, like in March 31st my master's will be ending, so before that I need to get a certificate of B1 so that I can apply for jobs.
Yeah, that's easily possible.
So
By February end, I'll make you ready. Not a worry. Okay. By March mid, I'll make you ready.
okay,
Yeah.
that's why I was like
So you tell me one
fully.
thing, as you told me that you have already done till B1. So see, now there are two things that you want me to start from middle, or you want me to start from complete scratch, from complete beginning. What is your requirement exactly?
Like I need to know about the grammar, like basic speaking things and all. I know like commonly I know how to talk in German, but to pass the exam I need to know and be strong in the grammar. So that's the point
So
where I'm getting stuck.
exactly. So what I can feel is that I think you are speaking the language, but you are speaking it wrongly, right? And you are not having confidence whether you are speaking correctly or not. Even if you are speaking correctly, then also you are doubtful whether it is right or wrong. Something like that, right? Okay. See, in that case, now what I will suggest you that you start from the beginning of the course. Okay, right? You start from the beginning, because see, if I start from middle, let's say I just assume that okay, Jiva might be knowing, forget B1, you might be knowing A1, A2. If I do that kind of assumption, you know, that can create a confusion later for you, because you know, when I say A2, my expectation is at a particular level. Right, and when I start from mid of A2, if it comes out that you don't know accusative, you don't know possessive pronoun, you don't, right, this kind of small stuff is coming out. You don't know what is word order, how to, where to put time word. Small concepts are there, one liner concepts are there. So if it comes out later, these kind of things, then you know, it might create confusion for you also, and it might create confusion for me also. Okay, right. I can very well understand. See, you have already paid the fees somewhere earlier, and you know, like, I also don't want that you pay twice or thrice for same thing at different sources. Okay, that even hurts me. I don't want anyone to pay like this, that okay, earlier you have paid some amount there, and now you are again paying to me. Okay, but you know, that is the need of the hour. In that, what I can arrange best to best for you is, we will start the course from beginning, first thing. Okay, we will start the course from beginning. It might happen that you know, you have already done your A2 B1. It might happen that you will be a lot familiar with many of the topics. Okay, you will be a lot familiar with
That's
many
fine.
of the topics. So what will happen, we will be able to save time in those topics. Right, as I told you that, you know, we have like, you know, my A1 to B1 curriculum, as I told you today on WhatsApp, that we have 25 lectures in each level. Okay, so 25, 25, 25. Total, we have 75 lectures for A1 till B1 curriculum. What will happen if we are able to save some time, right? Just suppose that for a beginner, for Haben verb, it takes for me 1.5 lecture to finish Haben verb for a beginner. It might happen in your case, we are able to finish everything in just half lecture instead of 1.5 lecture. Okay. Like this, okay. small chunks of time we will be able to save. So what we will do in that, whatever time, whatever number of lectures we are saving, let's just suppose that 5, 7, 10 lectures we are able to save just because that you know the topics prior. Okay, so what we will do in those lectures, I'll take some grammatical structures of B2 also, which are very essential for speaking the language properly. Okay, so I will not charge anything for them because my charges are lecture wise. So we have complete package of A1 till B1. So if you are performing good, if you are able to save some lectures, I don't have any problem in taking extra topics of B2 in that also. Without any extra fees.
Thank you very much.
I want to deliver maximum out of this. Now it depends on you how much you are able to extract from me. Okay, right. That is the thing. But the point is that we will start from the beginning only, so that we are not having any assumptions and we are not having any gaps in between. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. If I start from middle, again the same thing will okay. This topic you don't know, this topic you know, it half of the time will just get wasted in that only. That's why.
Exactly. Okay?
Right.
Like I have seen so many, like I went through so many situations like in internet and also. Mm-hmm. It's like bit clumsy to me and it's not clearing my doubts and all. So
that's happening. Because you're starting the course from middle, that's why it's happening.
That is the only reason.
See, you know, Abhi, what's happening is that now it should not happen that after learning from me, you are again going at some fourth or fifth source to learn German. It should not happen. Your target should be learning German for the last time in your life and you will finish it with the B1 B2 curriculum by March or April. That should be your target. It should not be that again you are hunting some other trainer next year, then again another trainer. You know, like this, you will end up wasting your money and time, nothing else.
Exactly. This is the last thing I am having in my like bank account. So that's it. I need to invest.
Correct. These situations are very, very common for me, you know, and it is sometimes very difficult to explain to people. You know, people who people should join from beginning, that's not a problem. But people who come after learning something, it is very difficult to convince them because, you know, that's why we have a habit of, you know, you didn't tell me on WhatsApp that you have done your A1, A2, otherwise I could have given you a test directly. We never start from middle. People who come to me, I have done A2, I want to start from B1, we don't believe in these thoughts, we simply give them a test of A2. That, okay, this is a test, please write down the grammatical answer, with that everything will be clear, what you know and what you don't know, right? So that is how we, because, you know, we ourselves face problem in these situations, because, you know, otherwise what happens, just suppose that you say to me, Raman, I have done A2, now I want to start B1, and believing that I start B1, just suppose. Okay, so what will happen later it comes out that you don't know accusative, you don't know dative, you don't know A1, A2 topic. Now, our lectures are 1-to-1. Okay, so 1-to-1, we don't have monthly system. We have fixed number of lectures. So when I am taking you some amount of money for delivering B1, in that, how can I take B1 also and A2 also? I don't have that much time in that. Okay, that is the problem. So that's why we keep it very clear from beginning. Okay, this is what we are targeting, and okay, if we don't know, that's not a problem. Let's do it from beginning. No problem, no worries. Okay.
That's why I cleared you everything like that.
No need to worry for all that. That's a very small thing.
I know some of the topics, but the grammar, I'm really low. My
strength is grammar only. Okay, so after this you will not face any problem in grammar. Okay, so I have all the answers of grammar. Whatever question you want to ask, you can ask me in the grammar. So you will not face any problem in that. Okay, right? So that difference you will see from today itself. See what we'll do now. Okay, let's start now. And I hope you might have watched one or two videos which I gave you on WhatsApp. Okay, so see, today we'll be starting with one topic of pronunciation. You might already be knowing all that thing, okay, but still let's do that. I will give you some interesting tricks which will make the speaking things, which will make the reading things very, very easy for you. Okay, so I'm playing one video, that is a German ABCD video. Try to listen to that. I'll play it twice and then we'll move ahead with the rules of these letters.
Okay.
Yeah. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y und Z.
Once again.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y und Z.
So that is German ABCD. Okay, now you repeat repeat after me. A, B, C, D. Repeat after me.
Okay. A, B, C, D.
A, F, G.
A, F, G.
H, E, J, K.
H, E, J, K.
L, M, N, O, P.
L, M, N, O, P.
Correct. Then Q, R, S, T.
Q, R, S, T.
U, V, V.
U, V, V.
X, Y, und Z.
X, Y, und Z.
Correct, okay. That is German ABCD. So once again, I am playing again. Try to listen to it, okay?
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, und Z.
Yeah, once again.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, und Z.
Okay, so that is German ABCD. I'll send you this video. You can keep on learning it. See where you will need this video. I'll tell you where you will need this video. Whenever you have some capital letter in front of you, example, if I say BMW, Volkswagen, CD, okay?
Yeah.
Whenever you have a capital letter, you will not say BMW, you will say BMW.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is the only area, otherwise nobody is going to ask you this thing. And second, whenever, let's say, you just suppose to you go to your some government office, so they are asking the letters of your name. Just suppose that you say that my name is Jeeva, Ishaizer Jeeva. Okay, but they are not able to understand the spelling. In then you don't have to use the English letter. Like in India, you say J double E V A. It is not like that. You have to use the German letter.
Yeah.
Okay, so A, B, C, D, A, F, G, H, E, J. So you will say Yot, A, A, V, A. Like this.
Okay.
Yot, A, A, V, A. If someone is writing your name, if he is not able to understand the spelling, you have to learn the letters of your name. Let's say if my name is Raman, I will not say R-A-M-A-N. I will speak the German letters. R-A-M-A-N. Right? If someone's name is, let's say, Sudarshan, then what you will say? S-U-D-A-R-S-H-A-N. Like this. Okay? So always remember this video.
Okay.
I have sent you this video. You can download it, right? And you can listen to it 2-3 times. Right?
Okay.
Now we will start with the actual topic of pronunciation of these letters. So far what we have done, we have just done the sounds, right? We have just done the sounds, we have just done the names of letters, that A, B, C, D and all that thing. Now you have to see the actual sounds of these letters, that what is the sound of A, what is the sound of B, like this. So I have opened one PDF in front of you, no need to write down anything. All this PDF, everything I will send you today itself. You can take a printout later.
Okay.
So German, as you know, it uses the same Roman set of alphabets from A to Z. Basically, two parts are there. First part is your vowels, A, E, I, O, U. Second part is your consonants, B, C, D till Z. Okay? We will see the sounds one by one. First of all, I am drawing one table, B, D, G, P, T, K. What happens is, whenever any word in German, if it is ending with B, D, and G. Okay? Any word in German, if it is ending with B, D, and G, respectively, the sound will be per, ta, and ka. The sound of this B, D and G will be per, ta and ka respectively. So see the example, G, I, B. Speak this first of all.
Gib.
Geep. Geep. Okay.
Okay.
Then next is kind. Speak.
Kent.
Next.
Tag.
Tag. It's not tag, it is tag. G in the end is ka.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So tag. From today, you will not say Guten Tag, you will say Guten Tag.
Yeah.
Got it? So that is the actual tag sound. When you will see any native, they never say Guten Tag. They always say Guten Tag.
Okay.
Right? Okay. Next is A. First letter is A. A is having two sounds. A is having two sounds, okay? A and A is having two sounds, A and A. Got it?
Okay.
A and A, okay. Two sounds are there. After A, if you have one consonant, what is consonant? This B, C, D till Z, these are called consonants. After A, if you have one consonant, then it will have the A sound. Otherwise, A. So see the example, ALT. Count, tell me how many consonant?
Two.
Okay. Two consonants are there. Just hold on. See the next example. F-R-A-G-E-N. How many consonants after A directly?
Three.
Okay. No. Directly only one. Only G is there. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Then T-R-A-G-E-N. After A, how many?
One.
Right? Only one. So the rule is after A, if it is one consonant. After A, if it is one consonant, then you will have the A sound. Otherwise, you will have the A sound. Otherwise, you will have the A sound. So, after A, here it is two consonant. So, it will be A, ALT. Speak ALT.
ALT.
ALT. Okay. Then, next example. Fragen.
Fragen.
Next, Tragen.
Fragen.
Fragen and Tragen. Okay.
Tragen. Alt, okay.
Fragen and Tragen. Next is E. E is having the A sound. Always it is the A sound. So speak the example.
A.
Yeah, SN. Okay, SN and Egal.
Okay. SN Regal. Egal.
SNN Egal. Next is I. I is having two sounds. I is having two sounds, long E and short E. Okay? Long E and short E. After I, if it is one consonant, then it is long E. Right? Otherwise, it is short E. After I, if it is one consonant, then long E. Otherwise, short E. So, speak the example.
E. Te.
Yeah, ist. First is ist.
Est.
Next.
Wieder.
Wieder. Next.
Bild.
Okay. Ist, wieder and Bild. Next is O. O is having two sounds. O is having two sounds. After O, if it is one consonant, then it is O sound. Otherwise, O for awesome. Are you able to understand the rules which I am giving you?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, exactly.
So after all, if it is one constant, then it is O sound, otherwise O for awesome. So speak the example, first example.
Order.
Order, next. Zol. Single S is Z, okay. Zol, next.
Monat.
Zol, then Monat.
Monat.
And
Park.
Corp. Okay. Order is all Monat and Corp. Good. So B in the end is per, single S is the, double S is the. Okay. Order is all Monat and Corp. Then next is U. U is having the U sound. U is having the U sound. So speak the example.
Tune.
Next.
Mutter.
Tune and Mutter.
Mutter.
Okay. Tune, Mutter. And next is Shoe. Next is
shoe.
Tun, mutter and shoe. Next is B. B in the end is per and beginning or middle is B for Bombay. Okay. B in the end is per and beginning or middle is B for Bombay. So speak the example. First example. Belen. Belen. Belen.
Belen.
Next.
Oben.
Oben. Next.
Corp.
Corp. Next.
Gipt. Geep.
Corp and then geep. Belen, Oben. Corp and geep.
Corp and geep.
Correct. Belen, Oben, Corp, and
Keep. Geep.
Next is C. C is having the K sound, okay? C is having the okay. K sound, so speak the example.
Kite.
Hmm.
Camping.
Yeah, camping, camping, okay? That's camping only. Right? Then, after that, the next one which we have is D. D in the end is T from the table BDGPTK. D in the end is T. And beginning or middle is D for dog. Beginning or middle is D for dog. So speak the example.
Doom.
Doom. Hmm.
Bide.
Bide. Next.
Wider.
Weeder. Weeder.
Weeder. Weeder.
Hmm.
Bat.
Bat. Hmm.
Hunt.
Hunt. Weeder, bat and hunt.
Hunt.
Okay. Weeder, bat and hunt.
Hunt.
Simple? Okay. Next yeah. is F. F is C. This here, this EI is I. These are vowel combinations. So this I will tell you after this. EI is I and I is E. Okay. EI is I and I is E. So speak this example. This one. Bider and weeder.
Bider
and weeder.
Bider and weeder.
Next is F. F is for F sound. So speak the example.
Foul.
Foul. AU is AU. AU is a vowel combination. AU sound is AU. AU is
foul.
Okay.
Shaf.
Shaf. AU is AU and then next is shaf.
Shaf.
Good. SCH is shaf. So shaf. Next is G. G in the end is K and beginning or middle is G for gun. G in the end is K, beginning or middle is G for gun. So speak the example.
Gegen.
Gegen.
Tak.
Tak. Next.
Klok.
Klug. Gegen, Tak and Klug.
Klug.
Okay. Gegen, Tak and Klug. Next is H. H in the beginning is H, middle or end it is silent. H in the beginning is H, middle or end it is silent. So speak the example.
Halt.
Halt. Halt. Next.
Gehen.
Gehen.
Zehen.
Zehen. Halt, Gehen and Zehen.
Zehen.
Okay. Next is J. Okay. J is here. J is here. Speak the example.
Junge.
Junge. Good. Next is KLMNP. That is same. Kala, Manapa. That is same time. Okay. So speak the example.
Okay. Class.
Class.
Law.
Next.
Chicken.
Chicken. Next.
Keller.
Keller. Next.
Will.
Will.
Atman.
Atman.
Schwimmen. Rennen. Brown.
Brown and Lipper. Rennen, Brown and then next is Lipper.
Lipa.
Okay, Renan, Brown and Lipa. Okay, clear now everything?
Okay.
Okay, good. So let's take some more constant, then I'll send you this PDF first of all. You can go through them for 2 minutes after that. Okay, next which we have is Q. Q is having the sound with QU. QU. Q always comes with U. So that QU sound is qua. Qua. Okay? Qua. So speak the example. Square.
Square.
Square. Next is R. R is gluteal. Gluteal R means something coming from inside of the neck. Like this. Okay. It's also called as the French R. In French also they speak like this only. Like this.
Okay. Right?
So speak the example from here. Riser. This one. Riser.
Riser.
Next. Bruder.
Riser. Bruder. Schwester.
Correct. Riser, Bruder, and then next is Schwester.
Schwester.
Okay. Riser, Bruder, and next is Schwester.
Schwester.
Correct. Next is S. Single S is the and double S is sir.
Okay. Sir.
Single S is the and double S is sir.
Sir. Okay.
Yeah. Single S is the and double S is sir. So speak the example. Zingen.
Zingen.
Hmm.
Schloss.
Schloss. Schloss.
Schloss. Sloss.
Then next is T. T is T for tomato. Okay. T is T for tomato. So speak the example.
Tonkin.
Tonkin. Next.
Rattan.
Rattan. Tonkin and Rattan.
Rattan.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Next is V. V is for. For sound. V is for and W is for. V is for. Yeah, yeah. W is for. So speak the example.
Volkswagen.
Volkswagen. Okay.
Volkswagen.
Volkswagen. And speak this. Feel. Next one is
feel. Feel. Feel.
Hmm.
For.
For. Next.
Wasser.
Wasser.
Vegan.
Hmm. Wo. Feel for Wasser, vegan and wo.
Okay.
Okay. Feel for Wasser, vegan and wo. Next is X. X is X only. This image is a little bit cut from here. X is X only. So speak the example. X Strahlen. Speak.
X Strahlen.
Correct. X Strahlen. Next is Y. Y is having the UI. UI sound. Speak twip. Twip.
Twip.
Okay. Twip. And the last one which we have is Z. Last one which we have is Z. So Z is having the sound mix of Ta and Sa. Okay. Z is having the sound mix of Ta and Sa. So speak the example. Sight and Sook.
Sight and Sook.
Sight and Sook. Correct.
Sook.
Yes. Sight and Sook. Okay. Tell me. Any doubt till here?
No, no, no.
No? Sight and Sook. Like this we have to do. Correct. Then we have some combinations. Okay. ST is Ishta. Speak the example. ST is Ishta.
Ishta.
SP is Spa. Yes.
Sh.
Yes.
Sh.
SCH is Sh.
Sh. Again. For.
Yeah. SCH is Sh. TSCH is Ch. TSCH is Ch. Okay.
Sh. Yeah.
Ch. 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 Not Sh. It is Ch. Make it Ch. TSCH is Ch.
Sh.
Okay. Sure. 90% sound TSCH is Ch, 10% area in Germany they have Ch. So Ch is like something like Deutsch and Deutschland, like this. That is the Ch sound.
Okay.
Okay. And PF is for. The next one is PF, that is for. Okay. PF is for. Yes. So speak the example from here. Stuhl.
Stuhl.
Strafe.
Strasse.
Strafe.
Spielen.
Stuhl. Strafe. Strafe.
Strasse.
No, no, that is Strafe. For. Strafe. F. Strafe.
Strafe.
Yes.
Strafe.
Yes. Next.
Spielen.
Next.
Speise.
Speise.
Speise. Sport. Sprachen.
Expression. Expression.
Expression. Expression. Expression.
Tougher.
Fad.
Tougher and then fad. P-F-E-R-D is fad. Okay.
Fad.
Good. Okay. So what I'm doing is, first of all, I am sending you these two PDF files.
Okay.
Okay. One second. I'm sending you these two PDF files. So first of all, you download them, go through them till the letter, this whatever you have done, SPST, Strafe and all. So pronunciation part 1, then pronunciation part 2 till page number 2, till here. Okay. Take 5 minutes of time.
Okay.
Just go through the files first. Try to retain all the rules. And then we will practice some words after this.
Okay.
Okay. Download both the files. I have sent on Skype chat. Download it. Check it. go through the PDF files.
Yeah, I'm going.
Okay, I hope you have revised everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell me any doubt anywhere so far? Any letter?
No.
Okay.
Nothing.
Okay, come to my screen now. I have shared my screen, page number 3. The last letter which we have is CH.
Yeah.
Okay, CH is a combination. CH is having two sounds. See, this is important. Whenever CH comes after A or U, it will have the kh sound. Okay? It will have the kh sound, otherwise sh sound. Example, if I say NSCH NAK, AUCH AUK, HOCH HAWK. Okay? So, these are, you know, whenever it comes after A or U, if CH is coming, it will have the kh sound, kh. Otherwise, everywhere else, otherwise, it will have the sh sound. Example, if I say ish, station, or expression, like this, you can say everywhere, okay, CH is coming after E or I, so it is having the sh sound.
Okay.
In some areas of Germany, it's reverse. Some people say ik, you know, people, if you go to South Germany, nearby, that Italy, you will find the ik sound also very common, but we will not follow that accent. We will follow ish only.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Start observing these things from today. You know, there is one mountain called Jungfrau Hock in Switzerland, Jungfrau. Okay, that is the topmost peak of Europe. So that is the same word, hawk. So start observing these things from today. These rules will help you a lot. Wherever you are having any doubts in pronunciation, I am telling you, you will not face any problem if you remember these rules. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Now, see here, there are some words written. If you can see my screen, there are some words written in blue color and the meanings are written in the red color. So leave the meanings. Meanings we don't have to read right now. We will do the vocabulary in detail. Right now, what you have to do, just start speaking the words, only the German words you have to speak, and take the help of the rules which I have given you. Using them, you have to just pronounce them, just to speak them. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, start.
Gut.
Gut.
Gelb.
Yeah.
Morgen.
Hmm.
Freitag.
Hmm.
Hot.
Hoot.
Hoot.
Hmm.
Heben.
Hmm.
Lehren.
Hmm.
Haben.
Hmm.
Jodler.
Hmm.
Junger.
Hmm.
Jahre.
Hmm.
Jurist.
Yeah.
Klein.
Next.
Wecker.
Hmm.
Kissen.
Next.
Kuz.
Mm-hmm.
Mug.
Yeah.
Muss.
Hmm.
Warm.
Hmm.
Sturm.
Hmm.
Net.
Hmm.
Donner.
Hmm.
Given,
good. Then speak next.
Can you scroll down?
Yeah.
Okay.
Party. Hmm.
Prize.
Hmm.
Tapeta.
Hmm.
Kupfer.
Hmm.
Quark.
Hmm.
Qualifizieren.
Hmm.
Quittung.
Hmm.
Quorum.
Hmm.
Rollschuhe.
Hmm.
Rekt.
Rest.
Okay. Rest.
So because you can see it is coming after E. So sure. Rest.
Yeah. Rest.
Hmm.
Fahren.
Hmm.
Butter.
Hmm.
Super.
Hmm.
Sagen.
Hmm.
Messen.
Hmm.
Bessen.
Hmm.
Troy.
Troy. Very good. Troy. Next.
Troy. Flirt. Hmm.
Flirt.
Flotte. Flotte.
Hmm.
Bart.
Okay. Next.
Verkehrt.
Verkehrt. Yeah.
Fall.
Hmm.
Fear.
Yeah.
Fulga.
Hmm.
Warum.
Hmm.
Where.
Hmm.
Verwendung, anderswo, zu, blitz, kratzen, zeppelin.
Okay.
Yeah.
Next are the umlaut letters. Okay. So these two dots are called umlaut. So we have three letters: A umlaut, O umlaut, and U umlaut. Okay.
Okay.
A umlaut sound is A. A umlaut sound is A. O umlaut is your, and U umlaut is you.
You.
Yes. So A umlaut is A. Speak the example. Elter.
Elter.
Correct. A umlaut is A. Sound is Elter. Example Elter. Then O umlaut is your. O umlaut is your. So speak the example.
Schön.
Next.
Tour.
Schön and then Morgan.
Morgan.
Schön and then
Morgan.
Yes.
Schön and Morgan.
Yeah. Next is umlaut. Umlaut is U. U umlaut is U. So speak the example. Tour.
Tour.
Tour and Flusser.
Fuse.
Okay. Tour and next one is Flusser. Clear?
Flusser.
Yes. Elter, Schön, Morgan, Tour and Flusser. Simple?
Yeah.
Okay. Next are these vowel combinations. Double A is A. Speak the example. Double A is A.
Har.
Har.
And par.
Next is par. Then par. Next is AU. AU is having the AU. AU sound. Speak the example.
Frau.
Frau.
Next. Blau.
Blau. Then A umlaut U is Oi. Oi. Speak the example.
Oi. Fräulein.
Fräulein. And Bräunen.
Bräunen.
Okay. Fräulein and Bräunen. Next is double E. Bräunen. Double E is having the A sound. Speak the example.
Te.
Te. And?
Schnee.
Schnee. Te and Schnee. Next is EU. Ne. EU and A umlaut U is having the same sound, Oi. Okay? Oi. EU and A umlaut U is having the same sound, Oi. So speak the example.
Freude.
Freude.
Freude. Schu.
Schoi. Schoi.
Schoi.
Freude and Schoi. Next is EI. Schoi. Yeah, EI is having the I sound. Speak the example.
Fry.
Fry. And?
Nine.
Niner. Okay?
Niner.
Fry and Niner. And IE is having the E. IE is having the E sound. So speak the example.
Schreiben.
Sieben. IE is E. Sieben.
Sieben.
Sieben. And next is double O. Double O is O. Speak the example. Boat.
Long.
Boat. Double O is having the O sound. That is boat.
Boat. Okay.
Right? Last is beta. Beta is having the S sound. So speak the example.
Asen.
Asen.
Gross.
Gross. Okay. Asen and gross.
Gross.
Okay. Got it now? Till here?
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
Okay, good. Just revise this once again. Okay, this is pronunciation part 2. Revise page number 4 and this 6. Page number 5 and 6 of this once again.
Okay.
Page number 5 and 6, these three umlaut letters and the vowel combinations, because this is the most important thing. And then we will start with some passages. We will read some passages today.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I have shared my screen. There are some passages written. Speak them, okay? Read them.
Okay. One second. Okay. Hello, Ishaiza Tom Meyer.
You can leave the numbers. Read only the text, okay? Leave the numbers.
I can say the numbers.
You can leave them. If you want, you can leave them. Otherwise, you can say them because numbers I have not taught you. So, if you want, you can leave them.
Okay. Ich bin 13 Jahre alt und einen Student und schuhe habe gern ich Englisch, Französisch und Sport. Sport. Meine Lehrer sind sehr schön. Ich wohne in Stuttgart, Bahnhofstrasse 20-7001 Stuttgart. Ich habe ein Handy. Meine Handynummer ist 1234567890. Mein Hobby sind Fußball, Schwimmen und Computer spielen. Mein Vater ist Zahnarzt von Beruf. Meine Mutter ist ein Zahnarztin. Meine Eltern haben Zahnarztpraktische in Königstrasse, Stuttgart. Ich habe einen Bruder und eine Schwester. Mein Bruder ist 20 Jahre alt und er will auch Zahnarzt werden. Meine Schwester will Tierarzt werden. Sie studiert jetzt nicht viel. Sie nur 16 Jahre alt ist. Frau Müller, das ist schön. Danach fahren wir zusammen. Frau Schmidt, ja, wir trinken Kaffee und essen Kuchen in Kaffee neben. Supermarkt, sind da gut Kuchen? Frau Meier, gute Idee. And I can't see the rest of the words.
Yeah.
Still?
Yeah, wait for a second, it will load.
Frau Meier und Frau Schmidt gehen zusammen zum Supermarkt. Frau Meier, ich brauche Tomaten. Mein Mann will Salat essen. Ich werde 10 Tomaten nehmen. Frau Schmidt, Tomaten sind gut. Ich kaufe 5 Tomaten. Es gibt Lettuce zu. Frau Meier nimmt Kartoffeln nicht, aber nimmt sie 2 Gurken. Frau Mia kauft auch 2 Kilo Zwiebeln.
Zwiebeln.
Frau Schmidt will Brot kaufen. Frau Mia, das Brot ist nicht gut. Ich kaufe Brot in Bäckerei. Aber ist die Schokolade hier gut? Es kostet nur 50 Cent. Ich nehme 3 Bar Schokolade. Frau Schmidt, es gibt noch ein Sonderangebot. Mineralwasser und Orangensaft sind billig. Frau Mia, ich habe Orangensaft zu Hause. Aber brauche ich 5 Mineralwasserflaschen. Frau Schmidt kauft nur 3 Mineralwasserflaschen. Frau Mia und Frau Schmidt gehen zu Klassen. Danach gehen sie zu Kaffee. Frau Schmidt trinkt eine Tasse Tee. Frau Schmidt Tasse Tee. Frau Schmidt trinkt Kaffee. Sie befehlen 2 Stück auf Schokoladekuchen. Sie nehmen den Bus zu Hause. Hallo Mario. Marion. Ich bin es, ihr Daniel. Ich hoffe, Sie tun gut sind. Ich wohne in Berlin. He affinde ish good job. Ich bin sehr glücklich mit meiner Arbeit. Mein Arbeitskollegen sind sehr gut. Sie willkommen mir mit offen Arme. Jeden Tag lerne ich etwas über das. Heute zeigen Sie mir senden Brief mit einem Machine. Das ist wirklich aufregend. Mein Arbeit ist gut und ich bin sehr froh mit meiner Freundin. Sie ist Verkäuferin von Beruf. Sie arbeitet immer am Morgen. Ich habe oft am Abend arbeiten. Leider nicht sehen wir oft nicht gegenseitig. Aber genießen wir jede Minute und sprechen viel gegenseitig.
Okay. Wir you fahren can say gegenseitig also. Yeah. Okay. IG sir sound, you can say gegenseitig also. Okay.
Zeitisch, yeah, yeah, like Zwanzig and Zwanzig.
Yes, yes, both are correct, but Sha is more common. Okay, Sha is more common.
Okay, Zwanzig, okay, okay. Wir fahren zu Sie waren
der Urlaub. Zu Z, double E is A, Zu Z, okay, Zu Z.
Zu Z, okay, Zu Z waren der Urlaub. Wir haben gern schwimmen und genießen. Die Wahlen. Insbesondere wenn scheint die Sonne und es ist wirklich heiß. Wir fühlen sehr gut an den See. Das Wasser ist kalt und wir können auf den Strand in Schatten legen und lesen ein interessantes Buch. Sehen für Schellen viel Spaß ist oder wir bauen groß Schloss. Da verbreiten wir unser Handtuch. Wenn das Wetter nicht gut ist, gehen wir bei See spazieren oder wir fahren nach der Stadt und einkaufen. Ein Urlaub immer gut auf See vor Sommerpause.
Okay, good. Right? Clear till here? Everything?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So, this is the thing. Now, see, I'm sending you this file also so that you can go through it later. And this is our demo lecture. So, a few more things I'll show you. How we will be doing the assignment, class assignment, home assignment. That also I'll show you what kind of Google Sheets which we are using. I have shared my screen. See here.
Yeah.
See, I've opened some assignment sheets. I hope you can see them.
Yeah.
So you can see this kind of Google Sheet we are using for assignments. Okay. So whatever topic, you know, you can see from the beginning of the course, right? This is a sheet of a father-son duo in Germany, right? Class 5-year-old kid and his father. So both of them are learning. They are very soon going to write the B1 exam. They are like around 2/3 of the course they have done. So I think they are in the last stage of the B1 thing. So you can see from the beginning of the course, sein verb, indefinite article, possessive adjective, haben verb. Okay, you can see the verbs, conjugations, you can see the efforts, you see the length of sentences. As you move ahead, once you go there, you can see the length of sentences which they have practiced, right? So you can see what clarity of grammar they will be having when they are writing so much. So no need to worry for all that. I can open hundreds of such sheets. You can see one more. So many more I can open. Like this is the way we'll be doing the assignment. Okay. So see, the initial flow will be that we'll be stressing more on the grammar initially.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. If I give you the breakup of the course, now, so how we will go ahead? A1 till B1. Okay. Oh, sorry, B1. Okay. We have total 75 sessions. So out of that initial 1 till 45 sessions, we will be focusing completely on the grammar and the vocab, right?
Yeah,
your target should be that by the end of 45th lecture, your grammar should be complete and your vocabulary, required vocabulary. See, vocabulary is endless thing. Okay, in a dictionary, you will get more than 10 lakh words. But we have to pick out only the 3,000 out of 10 lakh.
Okay, so those 3000 are something more than enough for your entire life until you are there in Germany. More than that, you will not need any word. Okay, so by this time, we have to finish that much so that, you know, by the time I say that now we are about to finish the grammar, you should yourself say that now I am in a position to speak with the people. Okay, and after that, the remaining one third, whatever lecture number 50 to 75, remaining one third, we'll be focusing more on the exam. Okay, if you have cleared B1 exam, that's well and good. But after that, I want that you clear the Gyothe B2 exam, if B1 you have already done. Right? Okay, Gyothe B2, it depends on that. See, B2 only in the case that we are able to save some time. Otherwise, you can clear the Gyothe B1 exam, or if you don't want to write the exam, you can put the remaining lectures on just German to German communication, simply. Leave all the exam and all. Because I think exam you have already done, so leave that. No worries of exam. Okay, B2, we'll see if it is possible in this target, we'll be able to finish. But as of now, we are making A1 to B1 target, first of all. So, at that time, if you don't want to write the exam, you can focus more on the listening and the reading skills at that time. But this is the target which I am giving you, that by 1 to 45, we should be done with the grammar vocab. And the last one third, we'll be focusing morely on the German to German communication. Okay? Right? We'll not use any Hindi or English, nothing. Everything will stop at that time. Complete German to German mode will start by the time you reach this stage. So in this, all this grammar, everything I will be taking, right? So I'll be taking all these topics, and the last, let's say 46 to 75, last one third, my wife Shivani will be taking the last one third, which will be focusing complete in German to German pattern. So both of us are using that. So whether you take A1 or whether you join C1, it's like that only, that all the grammar I am taking and all the listening and all the other exam stuff and the German to German practice, everything she is handling. So like, that's the way we are managing that thing.
That's right.
And each lecture is of 1 hour of duration, and the time which you have to decide, as I told you on WhatsApp, see, after 1 hour, you have to study for 2.5 hours. Okay, to other people, I say 3 hours, but you have already done your A1, A2 earlier, so I will not stress you much. Just study minimum 2 to 2.5 hours. Just please devote this much time. Okay, if you devote this much time, then only this, see, I'm telling you very honestly, language learning is not in the hand of a trainer, right? If you are learning from a bad trainer who does not himself know how to teach, then it is your bad luck. But by chance, if you are reaching at the correct place, if you are learning from the correct person in the correct way, after that, the actual thing starts, that if you are putting the effort, then only you can actually get that result. If I teach everything, now just see today's example, for you it was very easy, right? You already know a little bit German, so you were able to speak this much passage so fluently. Okay, but just suppose that if a person is there who is learning the language for first time, right? You know already that, so that's why it was easy for you. But just suppose for a person who is beginning the course now, for him, I ask them to revise these rules for 1 hour or 2 hours. So if they revise after the class, then only they are able to speak this passage. Otherwise, it becomes very difficult for them from day one itself.
When I went to like German classes here in Volkshochschule, they have not yet done this.
Nobody takes this. Whether you go to Volkshochschule, whether you go to VHS, whether you go to Gyothe, whether you go to Telk, I'll not take anyone's name, and I will not praise myself. But I know the reality, because I'm having students from more than 10 countries. So I know the reality, what they are doing, what they are not doing. So I am not saying that I am the best and they are not the good. See, everyone is good. Everyone has their own style of pattern. But what I have done is that I have noted their weak points. Noted their weak point, that people are facing problem because of this. You know what they do directly from day one? They will start with the greeting, counting, and guten morgen, all that thing they are doing, So you know, if you don't know how to read out and this is the problem in German, the pronunciation. The problem is they write something else, they speak something else. That is the trouble in this language. It is not like English or not like Spanish, that whatever you have written, that only you have to speak. You know, if you see Spanish. If you know English, you don't need these kind of rules. You can directly start reading out the words in Spanish. That is the easiness in Spanish. Okay, but the things are totally opposite in German. They are writing something else. They are speaking. The sound is something else. That is the thing. Okay, so that's why all these things are required. Step by step, we'll go ahead. Okay, so that's the thing. Just revise everything. Put a required amount of time, and then it will be very easy. If you are devoting this much amount of time, I can tell you, nobody can stop you from getting good result within 4 or 5 months.
So
just follow this ratio. Yeah, yeah. Just stick to this. Okay, no need to take that much stress also. I'll not make you study for 5-6 hours, nothing. Study for 2.5 hours and close your laptop. No need to study more. It's very easy after that.
Okay.
Right? Okay. So that's the thing, right? Just hold on. Let me end this session. One second.